Hello and welcome to the final ever show of Studio 11. We're going to end this... I know, guys. We're going to end this series with a bang, and boy, do we have a show lined up for you. I'm David Waldridge, and today we'll be chatting to top rock clothing designer Lottie Cunningham and showing you some of the best attractions as well as some fantastic hobbies that may just take your interest. So, if that's not enough for you, let's have a quick sneak peek at what's coming up on today's show. We put our headphones on and get ready to drop some mad beats as we head down to the Heights to hear all about how to DJ. For all you comic lovers out there, we head to the NEC Arena in Birmingham to check out the MCM Expo. And finally, we're off to Edgbaston to take a glimpse at the beautiful Botanical Gardens and all its wonders. In the studio live today, we have Panda Watch to play us two fantastic tracks. To top it off, we also have Lottie Cunningham here to tell us all about her clothing line. But before all that, we are heading off to the University of Birmingham to meet Bob Spower to learn all about the tough and rough martial art of Muay Thai, which is really hard to do after seeing it myself. I can't do it, so let's see if you can give it a try because I'm still unsure about it. Check it out, guys.
I'm gonna go through the motions. Come on, drive that knee in. So we send them back. So we go. Let's do it.
Now we've seen some of the action, let's go over and have a quick chat with Bob.
Muay Thai is considered to be an ancient art of Thailand. In fact, its history only goes back about 400 or 500 years when it developed as a fighting sport. And in recent years, literally the 1940s, it became the modern sport it is today. Two sessions on a Wednesday night at the university and two on a Friday night. The first session is a technical session, like the one we have here tonight, the one you can see going on behind me. That's where we concentrate purely on technique. Then we start to make a difference with a fighter spot. That's hard. There's no, I don't care how many people turn up for that class. It's not commercial at all. It's about getting people ready to fight in the ring. So it has a different intent behind it. This is having fun, getting fit, learning to defend yourself. What distinguishes Muay Thai above all is its use of equipment. So immediately you start punching, kicking, elbowing, kneeing against pads and equipment. So you're getting an immediate response from the kit. If it works, the pads move, as you've probably seen, you know. When you hit things and they don't move, it means your technique's not right. So Muay Thai gives you that instant gratification, which is what a lot of people find great about it.
Thank you for joining us today. This is everything we've got from the University of Birmingham and their Muay Thai team. So on that point, I'll send you back to the studio and thank you very much.
That looked quite rough. I better stay out here in the sun and have a cocktail and two instead, I think. We'll soon be joined by Panda Watch live in the studio. But right now we have Lottie Cunningham here to tell us all about her clothing line, Top Rock Clothing. So tell us more.
Top Rock Clothing is an urban dance brand.
Oh, fantastic.
It's mainly designed with dancers in mind, all clothing, mainly t-shirts, jumpers. We don't have any joggers or anything as yet. We have an online store and we also go to various dance competitions and events up and down the country, showing off our stock.
Oh, fantastic. So it's the clothing line started from the dance group, is that right?
Yeah. It's I've got a dance school and it originally started because I designed clothing for all my dancers because it was an easier option.
Oh, it was an easier option, was it? How did that come about? How come it was easier?
Basically, because it's really hard when you've got like 20, 30 kids.
Oh, yeah.
All different shapes and sizes to get them all the same costume. So me and my partner sat down and this is where we came up with our first concept, Born From A Boombox. And it really kind of took off from then. Quite a lot of dance schools got interested and asked us about it.
Oh, so they saw like you're amazing amazing outfit, and just like, how did they get that? We fought so hard then. Oh, okay. And so you brought some stills with you today about kind of designs you have available?
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. Fantastic. So talk us through this one then, Lottie.
Okay, these are some of our older designs. Like, this is when we very first started. Mm-hmm. They're all quite poppy, our designs, as they're aimed at the kind of 10 to 16 year old age bracket.
Right.
But that doesn't mean to say the older generation can't wear them too. All with different dance slogans. That one there is BFAB, which is one of our most popular ranges. We have a few different variations of that. And then we've got another one of the boombox ones with a Rhythm Junkie hoodie in the middle. Mm-hmm. They're all quite urban styles, although, like I said, they still keep it quite poppy, quite bright, and mainly street dance.
Right, okay.
We've got the Born From A Boombox in pink. So the other one was green, that one's pink. And although we've got girls modelling those two designs, we can use them for boys or girls. And we have a real mixture of different people ordering from us.
Okay, so was the Born From A Boombox the very first one you did for your group then?
Yeah, that was the first one that we did. And then that's when, after all the interest from that, that's when we decided to sit down and come up with a few different designs.
Yeah.
And it's still trial and error. There's still some that we'll do and they don't go down quite so well. Yeah, so we really have to trial them at the competition to see what dancers actually like.
Okay, so what kind of material do you use? Because what dancers like would like.
We mainly use a kind of Fruit of the Loom Gildan jumper hoodie with a vinyl print. And you can have it in so many different colours. It gives us a lot of opportunity to make some really diverse and interesting designs.
So how do you make it stand out, like, with that bright colour? Is that vinyl, is that?
Yeah, neon vinyl.
Okay.
And it's also the colours we use. We'll never use, like, a bright pink. When we're asking for our print, big and bright.
Big and bright, that's what you aim for. Well, that's amazing. We're going to talk to you again later with some more designs you've got to show us as well.
Yeah, with some of our models,
Fantastic. Well, we'll catch up with you again later for that one.
Thanks.
But right now, everybody, is PandaWatch live in the studio. That was simply great. Well done, guys. Coming up, we're heading to the NEC Arena in Birmingham for the MCM Expo. But now, we're in this final series of Studio 11. We're checking out various hobbies for you to get involved in. We headed down to the Heights and learned all about how to mix tracks with DJ Ash.
Basically, one day I was really bored, so I decided to just go across the internet. And then came across Virtual DJ somehow. And then I downloaded it, started using it, it was a bit fun. And I thought, might as well. Just kept on. To be honest, not really. I'll do it for the money, because money's good. But to expand, not really. Just do it for fun, really. I had more of support from my friends, but in terms of physical help, not really, no. So obviously, over here we've got the jog wheels, we've got our little browser, so you've got our highs, mids and lows. Obviously you've got your play, your sync button, your cue points, your crossfader, etc, etc. There's your pitch, it's your pitch and tap lock, this is your key lock, so yeah.
I've got some mixing to do, so you don't need to go.
Well, those were some simply amazing mixes. I hope to hear them on future nights out. They sound absolutely great. Soon, we'll be back with Lottie. But before that, if you're a big fan of TV shows like Merlin, Primeval and Doctor Who, you're in for a treat as we head down to the Media Comic and Media Expo at Birmingham's NEC. Check it out, guys.
Hello, my name's Sophie Sparham and today I'm down here at the MCM Expo 2013 to speak to some of the stars and their fans about the pros and cons of comic collecting and memorabilia. I'm now sat here with the beautiful Hugh, who played the very famous Colin Creevy in Harry Potter. How are you doing?
I'm very well, thank you. Yes, not bad.
So, how are you enjoying the convention today?
Yeah, it's good fun. Yeah, it's always a bit of a laugh. So I always forget how weird it is to just see everybody walking around as stormtroopers or Ezio or just people out of video games, and it just to be totally normal and casual.
And do you feel like, is it something nice to you, feel like when you sit here and you have fans come in and you get to meet them, is it something that you feel like quite honoured that people are such a fan of
it? Yeah, it's weird because it's this film, but you know, I was only in one of the films and that film came out 10, 11 years ago, and people are still crazy about it. And you don't get that with a lot of things, a lot of films. So Yeah, definitely.
So what kind of, you know, made you want to come down today? What people are here that you want to see and stuff?
I just came down for the atmosphere of it. It's nice to have a load of like-minded people just chilling out, dressing as whatever they want and just having a good time, really. Just all the rest of the stuff's a bonus.
I've got to say, you do see some characters, don't you, here?
Yeah, no, definitely.
And I'm such a people watcher. It's been great. I've just been all day signing and looking and being really nosy. I love it.
What do you think your favourite person here, like, that you've seen today is?
Today? I think it was Arnie. I think he was brilliant.
Yeah.
Hello, Samantha. Yes, you are all real women. There's no fake boobies here.
Bless him.
He was funny.
So, it's been a surprising day at the MCM Expo today. We've met some brilliant people, including Darth Vader himself, which I still can't really get over. And we've had a better insight into what people to come down here to do. Until next time, I've been Sophie Sparrow. See you later.
That looked like a lot of fun. I think I'll have to head down there myself next time. We'll soon be off to Edgbaston to check out the beautiful Botanical Gardens. But right now, we join back up with Lottie. But we're also joined by the lovely Lauren and Aideen from the Rhythm Junkie dance class. So, Lottie, take us through what these two are wearing.
Okay, so first of all, we've got our Born From A Boombox design, the original one, as I was telling you about earlier.
Mm-hmm.
This is the neon green one, again, in a lovely black jumper. It is one of our most popular designs, purely just because it stands out, it's bold and it's bright. And even though it's older, it still sells, so we've kept it on the website and people seem to be happy with that.
Okay, fantastic. And then take us to what, Aideen's wearing over here?
Next, we've got our Dancer Barcode t-shirt. Mm-hmm. This only comes in a white.
Yeah.
It's more popular amongst, like, say, maybe more edgy, raw.
Yeah, because it's not really so standout and poppy, is it?
Yeah, it's not as poppy as the other ones. And we've also got a custom QR code that we've kind of expanded on. So we do custom QR codes for dance schools and even dancers where people can scan it in and it'll take you to their website.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Or even YouTube videos, yeah.
Okay, well, if we go back over to Lauren here again. And take us through what she's wearing.
Okay, this is actually one of my personal favourite designs, not just because it has the name of my dance school, but also, because it's nice, bright pink. But we did have a bit of controversy with this one at the start because other dance schools, maybe in the Midlands, weren't so fussed on this, maybe due to our dance school.
Oh, I see, because obviously they don't want your dance school, their dance school.
Elsewhere, though, it's fine, it still sells quite well.
Mm. Yeah, because Rhythm Junkie's quite a, you know, nameless quote.
Cool.
Easily usable, yeah.
Yeah, I'd say so.
So take us through what Aideen's wearing.
Okay, this is our Keep Calm Dance On t-shirt. We do this in a range of different colours. It's mainly because it's a really popular craze at the moment. Everyone's doing the keep calm, like drink tea, keep calm, go crazy. Yeah, anything.
Yeah.
Well, we actually were one of the first to come
out
with it.
Oh, yeah,
of course we were. But it's actually become more popular since more people have jumped on that bandwagon.
Okay. So if we go back over to Lauren one last time, take us through your stop.
Yeah, we've got the Dance Nerd t-shirt in white. We also do this in a jumper. And it's popular because it's quite a craze as well to be a nerd.
Yeah.
Especially amongst dancers. When we go to shows, we sell that with the type of glasses you can see on the t-shirt, braces.
Oh, so it's a whole outfit. That was quite cool.
Yeah, and people tend to, once they've seen it with the t-shirt, they'll tend to buy the little accessories to go
fantastic.
With it as well.
Okay. So if we go back to Aideen one last time. Take us through this one.
Yeah, YOLO, you only live once.
There you go, the craze that's sweeping the nation.
Yeah, it is all based on these crazes, these dance crazes, and we really expand on that. We've got this one in an orange with white writing, white with pink writing. We don't have any jumpers of that of yet, though.
Oh, okay, well, once again, thank you for coming in today and telling us all about your Top Rock clothing brand. We wish you all the best with it. I hope it all goes well.
Thank you. I really hope
to see some joggers and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Let me know when you bring them out. But taking us out now, guys, is the one and only Panda Watch, which will be later on. But now for all you ones that love jaw-dropping scenery, we're heading off to Edgbaston to the beautiful Botanical Gardens. You don't want to miss this, guys. Absolutely beautiful sights.
Mm-hmm. the Temple Gardens. The gardens were first designed by a Scotsman of high enough landscapes in John Claude and Gordon, whose dream was to preserve green areas and rapidly used fertilizers. The gardens were first created in 1832 under the name Garden Essence, and each part was considered individually to ensure that they're grown.
Really interesting stuff there, not too far a journey, so get down there and have a look for yourselves. Well, that's it for our final ever show here at Studio 11. We would like to thank all our special guests and wonderful bands who have given up their time to entertain us, and we would like to thank all the crew for all the hard work they put into this series, and of course you at home for tuning in. After 14 years, we're going to roll the credits one last time, but not before we go out on a high note with Panda Watch.
So I find myself alone, not doing well, counting down the days till I can go back and hide from what I've found. No chance I'll hang around. Now I don't believe in what this might be, and all the days I've spent with you stuck inside my head, I lack the guts to tell you how I'm feeling. Fucking up, feeling left out in the dust. Far too much on me to get a grip on. Take me away from all these voices chatting in my head. Maybe if we try, we can start over again. Blur the lines between the simple black and white. While I ponder on the grey, I watch my watch you count the days. Been a year since you've earned this hand. I've dropped a ball to pick it up just while I'm staring at the clock. I'm overworld, the world away, and in my world I'm always safe.
No, I'm lonely, sadly.
Our meeting words can fly away, but history. And no one ever felt the same. Take me, take me. take me away from all these voices shouting in my head. Maybe, maybe, maybe if we try, we can start over again. Cause it-